Since we're mobile detailers and we do 2 to 3 vehicles a day, when we're doing an interior cleaning, we have to dry the interior as much as we can so it doesn't really interrupt the customer's day, right? We get customers all the time when they ask us about our interior cleaning. They'll say, or they'll ask, hey, is it gonna take the whole day for the seats to dry? Are the seats gonna be completely wet? Because in the past experiences, the carpeting, the seats are drenched when they get the car back from like a local car wash. So for us, we wanna dry the vehicle as much as we can before we leave the job site, just so that it's more of a convenience to the customer, and also so we can inspect the seats, the carpeting, the fabric to make sure that no stains are wicking back up or we didn't miss anything, or so we can make the touch-ups that we need before we head off to the next customer. So I'll have the links to the product that I mentioned in the description box down below, but it's gonna be a two-part process, right? So number one, before you get to the drying part, you first have to have the right process in place, right? So we do not overly drench or saturate the seats or carpeting or fabric, whether it's in the pre-spray or in the extraction process, okay? So our step is we're gonna pre-spray the seats. Agitate. And then extract. Now, even when we're using the Aqua Provac, and now we're using the HP60 Spider, we are not oversaturating the seats or fabric with the extraction. Now, the system that we're running right now with the HP60 Spider, we have the Science Sapphire upholstery tool, which greatly reduces the amount of water that's being introduced to the fabric material. So the less water or liquids that you can put into the fabric, the easier it is for that fabric to dry because there's less water in it. So the specific upholstery tool that we have is meant to introduce much less water into the fabric, and it has a higher suction power through the upholstery tool, through the machine, to get more of that water out. Now, we use the same process with the Aqua Provac that we use on hundreds of vehicles, right? We still didn't just drench the seats. Now, you are gonna introduce more water if you're using a traditional head, right? Whether it's a Mighty, whether it's the Aqua, whether it's whatever, if it's just the regular ejection water that goes into it and sucks it out, you're gonna be introducing more water than the upholstery tool that we have. We still use it on hundreds of vehicles. It's nothing wrong. It just make sure that your process in itself is you're not oversaturating the fabric. That's the main thing. Just don't oversaturate the fabric. Now, I'd say a big portion of drying the seats is going to land on the process on how you shampoo and extract. That's a big portion of it. Now, going into the drying phase is, if it's relatively warm outside, I'm not saying it's scorching hot, right? We're in Texas, we're in Houston, we get nasty weather of heat and humidity. But let's say it's somewhat warm outside, right? It's a little warm outside. That's enough to get the interior dry to 80-ish percent by the time we're done with the detail. And the detail takes, let's say, 2 to 2.5 hours, 3 if it's really bad. Right, so by the time we're done, the interior will be around 80, like averaging out 80% dry, depending on how much we did, you know, how big the vehicle. It's gonna differ, but let's just say on average, 80% of the vehicle is dry by the time we're done, assuming it's on a relatively warm day. If it's a cold day, if there's no sun outside, if there's anything other than ideal conditions of warmth outside, the interior by default will take longer to dry. It's just, imagine this, take a wet towel, right? Go out in summertime when it's 85 degrees, right? Put that towel on a rack and just let it dry. How long does it take? I don't know, let's just say 10 minutes, right? You put that same towel, wet towel, and you take it outside during winter when it's, let's just say, I don't know, 40 degrees Fahrenheit, right? How long is that towel gonna take? Gonna take way longer, not 10 minutes, not 30, maybe 45, an hour and a half, 2 hours. I don't know, but it's gonna take way longer than if it's warm outside, right? So if it's relatively warm, and if it's hot, I mean, the interior will dry. As long as you have the doors, the interior will dry by the time we're done. If it's relatively warm, 80-ish percent of the interior will be dry. If it's cold, not 80%, maybe 60%, maybe 70%, maybe 50%, it's going to take longer. So when you're talking to your customer, you have to be very conscious of the weather that's gonna be for that day, right? You have to let them, hey, look, it's supposed to be warm outside, it's raining, or it's whatever, cold. Instead of the seats taking an hour and a half to dry, it might take a little longer, maybe two and a half hours. Just make sure you leave the, you know, explain it to your customer. Based on the weather, it's not gonna take XYZ much longer for the seats or fabric to dry. It's very key. You have to communicate with your customer. Now, let's set it. So we've already said, okay, the process is important, the weather plays important. Now, after those two things, then it comes to what do you use? What, you know, what third party source of air do you use to dry the fabric? Now, they're called air movers, right? Everyone uses this in the carpet cleaning industry, right? Air movers to dry the hard floors, the carpeting, whatever, what have you, right? So with us, we use primarily we use the Easy Dry Pods. I'll link it down below. The Easy Dry Pods. Now, why we like this one is the traditional air mover is it's directional, like one-way directional, right? You just put it on the ground and it just shoots air straight. With these, it shoots 360 air shooting downward. So instead of a typical air mover that just goes straight, the Easy Dry Pod shoots air 360 pointing down. And obviously that's gonna help out for us because it's gonna, you know, shoot down towards the seat, towards the carpeting. So that's what we use. Now, if it's on a cold day or not ideal warm weather, even if you put the air movers, you're not gonna see a huge bump in drying. Depending on the type of conditions that you're in. If it's raining, if it's cold, like those two things, and you put an air mover, I don't think it's gonna dry that much quicker, because I've done it a few times where it's cold, it's raining, like it's just crappy weather outside. I put the air mover because I'm like, hey, I gotta dry this seat, at least the front driver's seat, so the customer can sit in it. And I sit like 45 minutes, an hour, and it does not budge. So just know that when it's not ideal conditions, even with the air mover, even with using as little water as you can introduced into the fabric, it's just simply going to take longer. It's something, it's important to take note. So for us, like especially when we have it at the shop now and the customer actually has to drive it off, we'll start with the driver's side seat. And as soon as we're done with this one and we jump to the next seat, we'll put an air mover on the driver front seat. That way we give it as much time as possible for it to dry. Now, it's you know, we're going into summertime right now. We don't have cold weather anymore, so it's relatively easy. So we can get by, but in the winter months, it'll get a little bit more difficult because there's not much, you know, it's harder to dry in wintertime. So for us, 90% of the time, we're gonna start with the driver's seat because we wanna give that much, as much time as it needs to dry so the customer can sit in it and you know, go on about their day without, you know, and it's not like, even if it doesn't dry all the way, it's not like it's drenched. It's not like their whole butt and back's gonna get wet. No, it's like it's lightly damped is what we say. Like it's not drenched. It's not, it's just lightly damped. And it just needs maybe 30, 45 minutes more for it to be completely dry. That's what we say. You know, that's what we usually say. So we use Dry Pod, Easy Dry Pod air movers. Most air movers, I believe, at least the ones that I've seen, like, I don't know, I've seen quite a few air movers. They all can connect through each other, so you just plug one up to an electrical cord and then from there you just hook it on to the next one, and then you can just share the power and just continue the power line. So that way, like for instance, when we're doing an odor removal, we had four air movers going in at the same time and all plugged in through one air mover, one main air mover, and then you can just power the other ones through that one. So we personally go with that one. You could probably use any air mover, to be honest. The ones that we use are $100 each. Air movers are, they can get expensive. Like if you see some like heavy duty, like actual in like commercial air movers, they can get pretty expensive. So in, you know, in relative cost, $100 isn't that much for air mover. But you know, it would be like, right now we have two in the shop that stay in the shop, and we have two in the van that stay in the van. Ideally, we'd like to have four in the van, four in the shop, because it's just more of an efficient thing. Like instead of saying, hey, put a timer for 10 minutes on these front seats, and then after 10 minutes, put 10 minutes on the carpeting in the front. And then after 10 minutes, put 10 minutes in the back row on the seats. And then after 10 minutes, put it on the carpeting 10 minutes on the bottom portion. Instead of doing that, you could put two in the back on the seats, two in the front of the seats, 10 minutes, put 10 minutes, and then move them to the carpeting, 10 minutes in the front, 10 minutes on the back. It makes it easier to drive the vehicle. So that's how we go through the whole process of an air mover. Don't think like the air mover is just like that. Once I get that, every interior is gonna dry instantly. Eh, no, you gotta go through the process, the weather, then the air mover is where it comes in handy. Do we use it every single time? No. Again, if you're in a relatively warm climate, you don't really need it. Like when we're like peak summer, we're not gonna use them. The heat will dry it out. No, I mean, not instantly, but you get the point. Like it's not gonna be a problem. Like we're not gonna use them, at least not in the field. We're not gonna use them when it's peak 95 degrees outside. Like it's just not gonna be a problem anymore. So hopefully that helps. Hopefully I covered all the details. If you have any comments, questions, concerns, you can always leave them down below. Like the reason why I'm doing this video is because I get asked a lot on Instagram, what air mover are you using to dry the seat? So this is why I'm making that video. Drop your comments, questions, concerns, and if it's, you know, if it gets asked enough, I'll make a dedicated video, or if not, I'll just reply to your comment. So check the description box down below for the links to the air movers or the upholstery tool that I use or anything that I mentioned in this video. You can also check down below for the Detailing Business Class podcast, my podcast. I also have the Detail Group Facebook training group down below. You can check all those links down below. I'll talk to everyone on the next one.